excited that you're back to join us. We're here on an island and ready to learn.
Miss Twinkle, it's so hot and I'm thirsty. Do you have any water?
Well, if you wait a little while longer, water will arrive. It's almost time now. We do have an appointment.
You can't make appointments with water. How do you know when it's going to arrive?
Water travels in cycles through the air. Oh, it looks like this little drop is about to go on a journey. Come on, class, let's watch.
Ahoy, mateys! I've a story to tell. Well, when I was a young drop, my mom sat me down and she taught me the way that Earth's water goes round. Now I'll teach you this ditty so you can know too, and I'll sing the refrain of the seafaring tune. Evaporation heats water to vapor, it floats up high and condenses to clouds. As rain or snow, it precipitates and collects into places where water will crowd. That's why rivers and puddles and oceans abound.
What do you do after that?
We do it all again. Now the one thing I wanted when just a young drop was to see all the world from the bottom to top. And as time passed, I realized I'd nothing to fear, 'cause the cycle would go on for years upon years. Evaporation heats water to vapor, it floats up high and condenses to clouds. As rain or snow, it precipitates and collects into places where water will crowd. That's why rivers and puddles and oceans abound.
How often does the water cycle happen?
All the time. Now sing it with me. Evaporation heats water to vapor, it floats up high and condenses to clouds. As rain or snow, it precipitates and collects into places where water will crowd. That's why rivers and puddles and oceans abound. Well, lads and ladies, looks like it's time to evaporate again. See you when I come back around.